The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess,
Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who in your mercy led St. Clair to the love of poverty, grant through her intercession that following Christ in poverty of spirit, we may merit to contemplate you one day in the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The Lord God said to me, "As for you, son of man, obey me when I speak to you. Be not rebellious like this house of rebellion, but open your mouth and eat what I shall give you." It was then I saw a hand stretched out to me, in which was a written scroll, which he unrolled before me. It was covered with writing front and back, and written on it was lamentation and wailing and woe. He said to me, "Son of man, eat what is before you. Eat this scroll, then go, speak to the house of Israel." So I opened my mouth, and he gave me the scroll to eat. "Son of man," he then said to me, "feed your belly and fill your stomach with this scroll I am giving you." I ate it, and it was as sweet as honey in my mouth. He said, "Son of man, go now to the house of Israel and speak my words to them." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
How sweet to my taste is your promise.
How sweet to my taste
is your promise. In the way of your decrees I rejoice, as much as in all riches. How sweet to my taste is your promise. Yes, your decrees are my delight. They are my counselors. How sweet to my taste is your promise. The law of your mouth is to me more precious than thousands of gold and silver pieces. How sweet to my taste is your promise. How sweet to my palate are your promises, sweeter than honey to my mouth. How sweet to my taste is your promise. Your decrees are my inheritance forever. The joy of my heart they are. How sweet to my taste is your promise. I gasp with open mouth in my yearning for your commands. How sweet to my taste is your promise. Hallelujah. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart.
Alleluia.
The disciples approached Jesus and said, "Who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven?" He called a child over, placed it in their midst, and said, "Amen, I say to you, unless you turn and become like children, you will not enter the kingdom of heaven. Whoever becomes humble like this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whoever receives one child such as this, in my name, receives me. See that you do not despise one of these little ones. For I say to you, their angels in heaven always look upon the face of my heavenly Father. What is your opinion? If a man has 100 sheep and one of them goes astray, will he not leave the 99 in the hills and go in search of the stray? And if he finds it, amen, I say to you, he rejoices more over it than over the 99 that did not stray. In just the same way, it will be, the same way, it is the will of their heavenly Father that one of these little ones not be lost." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Kind of two aspects of the readings I want to talk about. The first being from Ezekiel. Now, Ezekiel is given the scroll of the Word of God, in this case, lamentation and wailing. And he places, he eats the scroll, and it's like honey to his stomach. One of the things that is important for us is that it does matter what we put into our minds. We put in the Word of God, we put in the spiritual reading, we put in the Mass. What do we put in? Or do we put in movies that are not so good, or reading that's not so good? Maybe it's not even evil, but does it lead us to holiness? It's an important thing for us to know what we're placing inside of our minds and our bodies, that it is good and healthy and wholesome. And that's one of the ways in which we grow in holiness, is what we place in our minds. The second thing I want to talk about is the gospel, because often we will read what we want into the gospel, and sometimes it's not our fault. In the gospel today, Jesus says to us, he brings a child in their midst and says, "Amen to you, amen, I say to you, unless you turn and become like children, you will not enter the kingdom of God," or that you will, "whoever becomes like a child or receives a child such as this, in my name, receives me." Now, we have a very much a positive view of children in our society. We see them as one of our greatest resources. But in the time of Jesus, they were seen as non-entities. They weren't seen with very much love, I guess, you might say. That they were some of the lowest of the low, like slaves. I think one of the best analogies we might have is inmates in prison. So it says, let's say it says, "Whoever receives one inmate such as this in my name receives me." At least in our minds, it changes the way that it looks. And what Jesus is saying is how we receive even the sinner or the tax collector or those that we do not like or those that we do not see as a part of our group, it really does matter. That Jesus even goes after the lost ones, the sinner, He goes after the one that is lost, while the 99 stay, while the 99 good ones stay. How we treat our neighbor, how we treat even the lowest of the low is important. It's important, and we know it's important, because during the time of Jesus, this was not the case. It wasn't the idea that you should love your neighbor as yourself. The idea of Roman religion was you did the sacrifices, and if you did them right, God left you alone, or the gods would leave you alone. Not so with us. We do the sacrifices. After all, we're here at Holy Mass, and that is good and blessed and holy, but it does matter how we treat other people, especially the lowest of the low. Let us now stand and bring our prayers before the Lord and God.
For members of the church throughout the world, may the Lord give us the grace to be like children, open to trusting his word. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations, may God fill them with a spirit of humility and service. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For children everywhere, especially those who suffer abuse, neglect, or violence of any kind, and those who advocate for them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here today, may the Lord increase us in faith, hope, and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful departed, may the Lord welcome them into his kingdom to rejoice with our Blessed Mother and with Saint Clare and all the saints, remembering today especially the living and deceased members of the Saint Clare Society and Gerald Zinkel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, we ask that you please hear and answer our prayers through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted. God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who called your handmaiden Claire to seek you before all else, grant that serving you through her example and intercession, with a pure and humble heart, we may come at last to your eternal glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promise in the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints, we sing your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, especially St. Clare, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, the glory of Jesus, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please pray with us now the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart, as though you have already come. I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Re- Renewed, O Lord, at the wellsprings of salvation, we humbly entreat you that through the intercession of Blessed Claire, holding more closely day by day to Christ, we may merit to be co-heirs in his kingdom of grace, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.